Now, I've talked a lot about zinc, vitamin D, vitamin C in relationship to the immune system, but I haven't talked about iodine. Iodine has a very unique influence over the immune system. Let's just start with the basics. Okay, you need about 150 micrograms, not milligrams, per day as far as the RDAs. There's a lot of people that are deficient. I'm talking like 2 billion people on the planet. So a lot of people are deficient. The best source of iodine would be from sea kelp or even shellfish or fish. And eggs have some, dairy has some iodine, but really it's in the area of fish and shellfish. And a lot of people are deficient simply because they're eating food from soil that's been depleted. And unless you're consuming food that's grown on soils that are close to the ocean, chances are you may have an iodine deficiency. Now, the iodine, of course, is needed for the thyroid, because if we look at the thyroid hormones, T4 and T3, T4 being the inactive version and then T3 being the active version, the 4 and 3 represent the number of iodine molecules. So definitely the thyroid is the gland that stores iodine and helps make thyroid hormones. But if you're deficient in iodine, your thyroid stimulating hormone can go up. Okay, let me explain what that means. So you have the pituitary right here, it's in your brain, and you have the thyroid, which is right here. And the pituitary sends a communication down to the thyroid, and that communication is called thyroid stimulating hormone. It has a couple functions. One function is it causes the thyroid to grow and get bigger. Another function would be to increase the release of T4 that can then be converted to T3 through your liver and your kidney. So if you get a test and you have high thyroid stimulating hormone, usually what that means is it's not quite connecting to the gland. Okay, so then the body will start increasing more and more to try to make the connection. Because what happens, these hormones down here, if they're produced in sufficient amounts, should send a feedback loop back here to turn this off. So if you're deficient in iodine, this could go high. There's other reasons for that as well, but that's one. The other thing that messes with the thyroid is estrogen. And it just so happens that iodine is a great mineral to help lower high levels of estrogen or estrogen dominance. So if a woman has estrogen dominance and they have problems with their menstrual cycle, they have extra fat around their lower part of their body, iodine is a very, very good thing. Also, if they have symptoms of high estrogen, like fibrocystic breast or a fibroid, iodine is good to help regulate that. In addition to reducing the estrogen exposure and really find out what's causing the excess amount of estrogen production. And before I get into the immune system, I wanted to touch on something that's very, very important. If a woman who is pregnant is deficient in iodine, there can be massive problems for the child. Intellectual disabilities, a lowered IQ, the child could come out deaf, stunted growth. So iodine and all of the trace minerals are so important if a woman is pregnant. So make sure that if you are becoming pregnant, or you know someone that's gonna get pregnant or is pregnant or lactating, make sure they take trace minerals. Very, very important. Okay, so let's talk about iodine in relationship to the immune system. Number one, it enhances something called dendritic cells. Now, what are dendritic cells? You have two parts of the immune system. You have the innate and the adaptive or the acquired. The innate is part of the immune system that doesn't really need any training. You're born with it. It knows what to do. It has a general effect on the immune system. But if there's a large attack by invaders, viruses, bacteria, it will hold the fort and get recruitment, a backup army from the adaptive or the acquired side. So this side handles day-to-day activities, and this side is more specialist, like your special forces. And so dendritic cells, they're like the communicator that helps coordinate both sides of the immune system. Okay, number two, B cell development. The B cells are part of this side over here, and they make antibodies to help develop immunity against the pathogen. Number three, iodine helps stimulate phagocytes. You have macrophages and neutrophils. They eat bacteria and viruses, and iodine can help that process. All right, number four, natural killer cells. Natural killer cells are enhanced with iodine as well. And these are the guys that basically punch a hole through the cell that's infected with the virus, put a chemical in there, and cause the cell to commit suicide. So these guys will help with two things. One, viruses, and two, tumor cells. Iodine also helps enhance the cytokines. Cytokines are communications. You have cytokines for inflammation and also as an anti-inflammatory communication too. So this is very, very important. And lastly, iodine is really good for memory cells in the immune system. So if you're deficient in iodine, the immune system can lose its memory and not remember what it has a defense for. So that's pretty much all I want to talk about. Sea kelp is the best source. You can probably just take one in the morning, a capsule, and you'll be good to go. Thanks for watching.